All talk, no action. Good to see you guys again. On today's episode, I want to talk about the field. It's something that we don't mention a lot, but there are two other professional lacrosse leagues that, believe it or not, the NLL is friends with. And I want to talk about our guys taking the field because the PLL just had a couple guys join off waivers who maybe some people wouldn't expect. So I want to get your take first on who you're most excited, what NLL players you're most excited to see take the field this summer. Jake Elliott, you go first.
I get to go first. I went last time. I'll go first this time. Good to see you.
Yeah, you can't turn me down again.
Yeah. like you mentioned, a couple of guys that just got picked up off the waiver wire yesterday in the Wiz from Halifax, Jake Withers, the Borough boy. And then you got the good Victoria boy over here on the West Coast. Both of them Ohio State Buckeyes, the natural Jesse King getting picked up as well. It's been quite some time since I've seen Jesse King play some field lacrosse. I want to say World Championships 2014, maybe? Mm-hmm. So that's a long time ago for me, and I can't wait. I love watching Jesse King play lacrosse, whether it's indoors or outdoors. So I'm real fired up to see Jesse. And then if I can just throw all the rest of the Canadians into the boat as well. Anybody that's rocking a Maple Leaf, Bird, Dixon, McIntosh, Courier, Dylan Ward, whoever, anybody, if you're Canadian, I'm fired up to watch you play some field lacrosse.
Yeah, it's interesting because the Canadian and American roles kind of switch in field lacrosse, right? Like, we are so accustomed to the Canadian guys kind of crushing it, and they still crush it in field, but you've also got those bigger American names. So speaking of, Brendan Glasheen, let's get your take.
Well, there's a player with Whip Snakes Lacrosse Club that crushes it in both leagues, and that would be Mr. Matt Rambo. What can't this guy do? I mean, comes off a college championship in 2017, plays one summer with the MLL in 2018, and then I can't think of a better stretch over the last 12 months that this young man has put together. Wins the PLL championship, game-winning goal. Jim Brown, PLL award winner, the best player. Wins the title again with the Whip Snakes. He goes on a 6 a.m. flight to Vancouver to help Team USA capture bronze at the World Championships.
Yeah, they only got bronze there, Brandon. They only got bronze at the World
Championships. Yeah, but still.
Capture bronze.
He was up late at night smashing beer cans across his head, and what do you know? He shows up and he plays lacrosse, the dude scoring goals. I mean, it's unbelievable stuff. And then just looking at progression from year one to year two in the NLL, I know the question said, which NLL star are you looking for, looking forward to seeing? He is a budding star in this league. 22 goals, 34 assists, 4 more assists in 3 less games played this year in 2020 for Rambo. Same amount of points, 56, 6 more loose balls. The guy is a machine. He's been fun to watch. I don't see how, and plus he won the championship last year, as I said, the Worlds, college. The guy is on a roll. I want to see him keep doing it.
So that, before we started recording, for transparency, Jake Elliott told me I needed to say my dream team from last week with more conviction. So I should have said that. Matt Rambo was my first pick on my dream team. I should have gotten, I'm going to have Brendan Glasheen write my speeches from now on.
Well, he's instantly on the all nine team with the last name like Rambo already. And yeah, like budding star for sure for Rambo. Like, I think the sky is the limit for this kid. Touraton winner, all the rest of it. And he's really starting to get the box game. The kid's a freak. He is. He's a winner and he's a gamer. And like Brendan said, he's going to be fun to watch this season.
Yeah, so, he's on a tear for sure.
Well, Brad, I feel like we just created a kind of USA versus Canada rivalry here. So,
That was born a long time
ago. I get to tip the scales then and rep the Maple Leaf one more time. And I'm going to go with Dylan Ward. I'm looking forward to seeing him play in the PLL this summer. That's D-I-L-L-O-N for anybody out there that's confused on how to spell Dylan. But this is a guy who's already world champion with Team Canada back in 2014, mind you. Was the MVP of that tournament and still, I don't think, gets enough respect as an elite field lacrosse goalie. And he really hasn't been a starter in the MLL until last season. And he finally gets nominated for goaltender of the year, wins the championship. But still, people are going to go, oh, wasn't the best competition last year. Well, now he's in a league that has the best competition. And Dylan Ward has a chance to show that he is one of the best, not just Canadian field lacrosse goaltenders, but best field lacrosse goaltenders, period. And, you know, there's not a lot of guys that can make the transition from, there's just nobody right now that's playing goal in the NLL and in the PLL, and that is a freak of nature kind of move. And he's going to be battling with Blaze Reardon. They're going to probably share a couple minutes and see who can take the reins, because that's not a guy that you're going to push out of a number one spot anytime soon. But if Dylan Ward gets a good shot this year, he's going to prove to people that he's going to be one of the best fielders across both players.
Is anyone else shocked that Brad did not pick the Georgia Swarm player to spot right here?
Yes. Yeah, Brad, you're changing your tune here. You didn't go with your usual
Lyle Thompson's too obvious. I think he's on. He's going to be the MVP of the MLL again this season. Yeah. That's a no-brainer.
May I add, Dylan Ward is a fan of the program. He said last week when I picked the Black Wolves to win the title, Dylan Ward says, of course, the dude that works for the Black Wolves picked the Black Wolves.
Oh, man.
Shocker. There's some shade on the program.
Did you tuning ever in. Get called out? Man, did he roast you on Twitter with that one.
It was great. Yeah. Good shirt. He's
really good at chirping on Twitter, I do have to say. But sometimes it scares me a little bit. So, hi, Dylan Ward. Don't chirp me on Twitter. All right. Question two is which, and like you guys, especially Jake and Brad, I know you're Canadian, box lacrosse is bigger up there. Which outdoor star who doesn't play in the NLL? So like, for example, this season we had Miles Jones join the New York Riptide, a huge USA player, but not so much in the box game. Is there someone who you'd like to see try their hand in the NLL next season?
Can we go reverse order this time? Let's go reverse order.
Sure, let's change it up. Brad.
Gutty, Justin Gutterling. Got into a handful of games with the Philadelphia Wings back in 2019. Performed okay too. Scored pretty much a goal a game and three assists in his first game in Philly, but took last year away from the National Lacrosse League. This is a guy I want to see back. He does nothing but score goals at any level that he plays at. He's the all-time NCAA goal scoring leader with his years at Duke there. That is a hell of an accomplishment with every fantastic lacrosse player that has come through the NCAA system. He was a fantastic goal scorer in the PLL last summer and also stepped up his feeding ability too. The guy was an essential playmaker for his squad last season in the PLL. So I want to see Justin Gutterling get another shot at the National Lacrosse League, you know. And Philadelphia still has his rights right now. So if he can play with Reardon and Rambo and Baptiste and the guys that go back and forth, that's a perfect fit for Justin Gutterling. So come back to the NLL, Gutty.
I would support that. He's a great guy, great player, and he's fun to watch. All right, reverse order still. Brendan.
That means my order does not change. Yeah, in fact, I would still be going second there, Jumbo.
I put
my investigative reporting cap on because I figured okay. If I'm going to say someone's name, I should probably maybe ask them or reach out if they even have interest. The gentleman's name is Will Manny, plays for the PLL Archers Lacrosse Club. Now, he's been in pro lacrosse for 6 years, going on seven this summer with the Archers. He played in the Boston Box League for 3 years when he was playing with the Boston Cannons of the MLL. It turns out he does have some conflicts coaching with the Utah Utes program. But I asked Will, I said, if there was a perfect opportunity where you could make it work with Utah as well as your PLL commitments, would you be interested? And his quote was, if I could, I would. Now, he was with the tryouts last year prior to the World Championships, but it turns out that 30-man training session, when they whittle it down to 30 guys on the roster for the training program, it interferes with Utah commitments. So it would be tough, but he's got the perfect game for it at attack. Great release point for a box player. I think it would be fascinating. PLL players put out a poll at the end of last year ranking all of the players, and he was the number 13 guy. So you mean to tell me he can't make the transition into box? He's been told before, he's been asked before. He'd do it if he could.
I'm capital J journalist right there, Brendan Glashine. I love the investigation and the sourcing. He is an incredible player as well, and he would be very, very exciting to watch. So if you talk to him again, tell him that, you know, if he ever sorts his Utah schedule out, we'd love to have him. Jake Elliott, are you ready?
I am ready, okay. And I did a little journalistic reporting as well. I tweeted at this guy about 2 years ago. He didn't reply to me, though, so that's kind of where the journalism stopped on that one. But my guy I would like to see go from field into the box is a guy that put up 25 Genos at the World Championships. Brendan, you were there back in the 10, yeah.
Oh, I know you're gonna go. I know what you're saying. Go ahead.
He broke my heart, Canada's heart, in that gold medal final, tying that game up late. But 25 goals, and this guy can crank with either hand upwards of 100 miles per hour. I don't know if he's ever played box lacrosse before.
I feel like I need a drum roll here. Like this, I'm getting nervous and anxious to find out who this person is.
Ryan Brown is your guy.
Okay.
And Team USA star. I think he plays for the Atlas, if I'm not mistaken. This guy is an absolute stud. He's lefty dominant, but he can fire with either hand. And all the experts say that this guy has got the best shot in lacrosse. So I want to see him get in between the boards. And if I can just throw one other guy in there,
is
number 99, Paul Rabel. Like, this guy's got an NLL championship with the old Stealth franchise. He's been in the league before. And of course, I know he's got all the commitments with the PLL and stuff. But listen, if we can get Paul Rabel back into the National Lacrosse League, I believe the Toronto Rocks still hold Rabel's right. So Jamie Dowick, I'm sure, would welcome Rabel back into the mix there. And if we can get Paul Rabel back in our league, I just think the trickle-down effect from that, guys will follow. And here's a guy that's won a championship. He's got box experience. So get me Paul Rabel, get me Ryan Brown into the National Lacrosse League, please, and thank you.
I love it. I love it. All excellent choices, guys. I know we're all missing lacrosse, so looking forward to watching some field lacrosse this summer. That does it. I mean, anyone have any final thoughts they want to say to close us out?
If I can just say to Teddy Jenner, taking a phone call while recording, a fake phone call while recording.
The disrespect, right?
Oh, the audacity.
The audacity. When I thought he did that, I was like, No. But I mean, I respect the move.
Devin, you know, here's a question. Here's a way to wrap this up. Devin, if you had to pick team two or team one to trust with money, clearly you trusted team one last week with dollars, fake dollars to make a team.
Yeah.
Are you saying that you wouldn't trust team two with a budget?
Oh, I would absolutely trust you guys with a budget.
Ah, there it is.
I think I would just be outdone by all three of you guys.
I
don't know. Jake told me I needed to say my team with more conviction. Like, I just don't know if I'd stand a chance.
That's what I said. I said, you just have to say it like you believe it, and then other people will believe you. That's how it works.
If you guys want to deal with money, we can certainly make that happen in 2 weeks.
Okay.
Oh, I gotta take a call, I think. So.
Okay. Well, go ahead. Apparently, you can do it while we're taping. All right, guys. Thank you so much. Until next time.